Howdy folks, Keith Bowen again, Hard Rock University. And while I was editing the videos, I noticed that lessons 5 and 6, using the extraction table, producing a number of different products, and trying to figure the mineral liberation and separation, it got really complicated. Since most people don't make a profession out of this, I wanted to make it simpler, and since most people don't have any kind of separation table or extraction device, except maybe a gold pan, I wanted to reduce it to its basic elements so that anyone could do this and determine whether or not your ore appears to be a reasonably good candidate for a gravity extraction. The first step for gravity extraction is, again, mineral liberation. You have to crush the rock to the point where the different mineral particles are mostly separated into individual particles. So, in order to do that, you have to crush it to an undetermined size. It's very ore dependent. However, I'm using 100 mesh as kind of an arbitrary number. It kind of marks the boundary between what's relatively easy to accomplish at a reasonable amount of money and what starts getting progressively much more difficult and expensive to grind. That is not set in stone, but it's a good place for a first test. If you can't get a good gravity separation at 100 mesh, you're looking at problems. If you do, then you would want to do the same test at coarser sizes so that you can determine what's the minimum grind you need to do to get good mineral liberation and separation. What I did was I started with a large volume of crushed ore that I have. I have two different samples from two different mines. And then I just sieved it in a 100 mesh screen. Now, this is not representative grade-wise necessarily of the original ore. Therefore, a sample on the original ore does me no good. Quite often the fines are richer than the original ore. So I screened a sample and then split it in two. This is just half of it. The other half is in the house going to be assayed later. For a sample size, I picked 1 kilogram, 1,000 grams even, because it makes the math real simple. At 1 kilogram, every gram of product you create is 0.1%. So it makes the calculations easy. Now, here we have 1 kilogram of 100 mesh minus. I don't know what the ore grade is. We'll find that out later. This water has been treated with jet dry. I'm going to take this, put it in the bottom here, and then start gently stirring it to get it all wet without giving it much opportunity to get out of the pan, just like before. Now, because this is so fine, you can get a lot of float. What I'm doing here is simply, first couple of times, doing it by hand. And then just draining it back out again to get down to the more workable material. This stuff is so fine it just tends to be slime and will literally just pour right out of the pan if you're not careful. Going very carefully and slowly decanting that. Let it settle a minute. Start pouring it. Now this is a very fine grind. If you were to grind your ore to this, the actual particle size of the ore will be about the same as the particle size of the larger gold particles in most hard rock ore, and that will give you a pretty good separation. Okay, now we're down basically to the black sands. As you can see, these are blondes right here. They very, very quickly turn darker as soon as we start washing anything off. Now at this point, to keep from screwing the results up, I'm pretty much going to stop. Because that, I can just see the black sands through the blondes there. So we're now going to stop. Right here, and I'm just going to pour the water off. Okay. There is our black sands. That's the equivalent of your gravity concentrates from your process. Now, we have our float. In any process, you're going to have some fine slimes that just love to float. So I'm pouring those into here. I'm doing it slowly and carefully. You can zoom out, Gonzo. Good. Okay. Now we have three different fractions. We have the concentrates, the tailings, and the slimes. This is what you would get out of a typical gravity extraction. Concentrates are what you're looking for. We are not panning down to the gold. We are not trying to get a clean gold concentrate, a smeltable gold concentrate, anything. We just want the gold in the gravity concentrate to see if it can be gravity separated. Here you've got your tailings. This should be, if the process was good and if the mineral liberation is good, this should have very little gold in it right now. 80 to 90% of the gold, if everything worked well, should be right there. There should be virtually nothing here and virtually nothing here. If you get something in the fine slimes, you got real fine gold that's floating off on you. Try and add some more jet dry or something like that. If that doesn't work, it may just be too fine to gravity separate. In that case, to get that, you're going to need to leach it. It will leach really fast and really easily because it is so fine. If you've got gold here, two things can be wrong. The gravity separation didn't work, or the mineral liberation was not achieved. What I'm going to do just for thoroughness is I'm going to go ahead and pan this again with fresh water just to make sure that the gravity separation has done its job. So the only thing in here should be due to mineral liberation issues. You need to dry all of these, weigh all of them, then remember, concentration times weight equals gold. So you start with the head assay times 1,000 grams. That gives you your total gold. Then you take this assay times however many grams this is. That tells you how much gold is in there. This assay times how many grams are in here. This times how many grams are in here. Tells you what's there. You do all that, see where your percentages lie, and that'll tell you whether you can get, whether you're getting good liberation and can get a good gravity separation. If you can do it in a pan, you can probably do it with a good quality separation device, be it a Wiffle table, certain jigs, Deister table, wave table. There's a number of devices, and we're working on one we really like too, but I'll have to tell you about that later after we get the patent paperwork filed. But anyhow, that's how you do it. It's something anyone can do with a screen, something to crush the rock, gold pan, very simple. And that'll tell you whether or not your ore is likely to work well with a gravity separation. Thank you and happy prospecting.